Do you know how to record refunds from vendors? There are different types of vendor refunds, but this video will show you how to record refunds from vendors from past check and expense transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Refunds could be from past transactions with vendors, such as checks, expenses, and bill payments. This video will only address refunds from past check or expense type of transactions. A later video will address refunds from bill payments or refunds from paid bills. What happened when we paid the vendor? Well, the cash in the bank went down because we paid, and the specific expense that we paid for went up, such as delivery expense, repair expense, and so on. What happens when a vendor refunds you the money? Well, obviously your cash in the bank goes back up because you just got the money, but the specific expense that was on the original bill or original check goes down. That's because if you got a refund, you never really had that amount of that expense in the first place. For refunds from check and expense transactions, you must use the Make Deposit window in QuickBooks Online. And you must also be careful to enter the original expense refunded from the original check that's actually being refunded. For example, let's imagine on April 8th, we received a refund from UPS for the March 7th delivery that we received on March 7th. A partial refund of $150 was directly deposited into the bank account. The bank balance before this refund is $31,393.40. Can you guess what it will become? It will increase by $150 and become $31,543.40. And delivery expense will decrease by the $150 and become $5,840. Let's take a look at how to record it. So, here's the trial balance with the numbers for delivery and for bank account before we record this refund. As we explained, we will have to use the Make Deposit window. Click here, go over to where it says Other, and the top choice is Bank Deposit. Now, the date that we're depositing the money is April 8 of 2017. Now, what money are we depositing? Well, we're ignoring the other undeposited funds that are here. We're going to set that aside for now. And we're going to tell QuickBooks that we received from UPS, which lowers our delivery expense by the amount of $150. So that means that delivery expense is going down by $150 and the bank account cash in bank is going up by $150. And of course, you could put the details in either the description or the memo field, and I suggest you do that. But after you click Save and Close, you will see the bank account has become $31,543.40, which is exactly what we predicted, and delivery expense has decreased to $5,840, exactly as it should. You should also know that you can deposit a refund check with another check from undeposited funds. For example, let's imagine on April 9, we received refund check number 5575 from Staples for $100 worth of equipment that was paid for back on April 1 with check number 61. We will deposit this check on April 10th with check number 40961 from Candy that we received back on March 14th. I suggest you concentrate on the top one here, April 9th, because this other one for April 10th, you could just click the check mark and they'll be deposited together. Let me show you. So, again, we click bank deposit. Now, the day we're actually depositing both checks is April 10. So you really should record it as April 10. Now, scroll to the bottom and fill out the bottom exactly the way we did in our previous example. We choose Staples, the account that we're decreasing or having less of as a result of the refund is equipment. And the amount we paid or the amount we paid less for equipment is 100. So this is basically filled out for the Staples refund check, except for the check number, which is very important to put. Okay, very good. Now, all I have to do is tell QuickBooks that this check that I just filled out is being deposited with this check, and we click the check mark. So if you scroll down to the bottom, you see the total deposit on April 10th is $4,300. $4,200 from the check from Candy that's been waiting over a month to be deposited at the same moment that we are depositing this refund check from Staples for equipment. Save and close, and the numbers in the trial balance adjust themselves accordingly. Notice undeposited funds has greatly decreased. It's decreased by the $4,200 that we just deposited here on April 10.